Amen. Today's offering nugget. We want to talk about Malachi 3, the tithes and offering, where everybody wants to use that scripture, and it's appropriate.
In Malachi 3, in verse 10, it says, "Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house, and the rest, and test me now, and this says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open up for you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there be room enough to receive it. I will rebuke the devourer for your sakes, so that it will not destroy the fruit of your ground, and the vines in your field will not fail to bear fruit, says the Lord of hosts. Then all the nations can call you blessed." Now, that is the standard tithe and offering scripture. That scripture is for tithing. Now, what the believer have a hard time, I don't say this until you understand that when you bring tithes to the storehouse, to the church, you're not giving to the pastor, you're not giving to that church or that ministry. Set your heart, your mindset, your affection on the things of God. Make sure that when you give, you're giving to God, not anyone else. Give it to God. Now, when you give to God, that's where you expect your blessings to come from. One of the things it says in the scripture, he says, "I will rebuke the devourer for your sake." I have been a tither now myself for more than 18 years. Or right about 18 years or so. And I can tell you, the things I used to experience before I started tithing, like flat tires, the alternator going out, transmission and heat pumps and all this other stuff going on with my cars, just to give you some examples, I don't experience that no more. I remember I bought a brand new 85 Volkswagen Scirocco, and I tell you, within 2 months I had a double flats on one side of the car. Brand new car, I couldn't understand it. The engine went out, the engine was going bad. I took it back to have it serviced because of the engine. And you know what? All of that is because the Lord was not rebuking the devourer for my sake. Now, since I've been living in Christ, I haven't had any car trouble. And I know that's not because of me. I haven't changed the style of driving I drive. I still got a lead foot. I ain't gonna tell you, I drive fast. So, you know, I'm working on that speed limit thing. But I tell you, I don't experience the things I used to when I was not in God, before I was tithing. So I'm telling you, try tithing, not to the church, not to the pastor, tithe to God. Is the foundational principles of why you give. In Exodus 35, he said, "He who has a willing heart, let him give." And then he said, in verse 23, I believe it is, it says, "For those whose heart he made wise, he allowed," they gave willingly. So allow God's wisdom to come into your life, to come into your heart, and be a giver. Now, I'll challenge you this. This is one of the only scriptures they say, "Prove me, test me." Well, I tell you what, tithe for 3 months. 3 months. Just try it for 3 months. If your life has not changed, if the stuff that normally plagued you still plaguing you, then stop. Just stop. Amen. Try it. If it don't work for you, stop. I say try things for a season. I said 3 months, that's just for you unbelievers, but if you really got some faith, do it for 3 years, do it for 7 years. And if your life is still the same after 3 years, 7 years, then go back to doing what you were doing. But for you, those who really been trying to give to God and it's not, and you ain't see the benefits of it, be consistent for 3 months. And if your life don't change, then go back to giving the way it was given. But for the rest of you, try it consistently for 3 years, for 7 years. And if it works out for you, glory be to God. This has just been a note from Kingdom Application Ministries. Apply the word. Let us apply the word together. Amen.